Good afternoon, baseball fans. Welcome back to Scotland Yard for our third and final game of the day of the Scott Classic between the McKinney Lions and the Highland Park Scots. Time limit will be 2 hours, 15 minutes. Time kept on the field by the umpires. Battery for the Scots behind the plate. Number 14, Henry Scherer. And on the mound, number 2, Harrison Duggar.
Game number 2 for the Highland Park Scots coming up here from the 2021 Scotland Yard Classic. This game will be against the McKinney Lions from McKinney High School. And we are about to get underway on the mound for the Scots for this second game. Will be Harrison Duggar as he prepares this first pitch to Jake Dupree. And that is a dead ball to start things off as Dupree will head down to first base after being hit by that pitch. Duggar finished last game in left field, getting a look at the bump for the second game. And that brings Bryce Johnson up to the plate. Johnson, the third baseman for the Lions in today's matchup. Scott's coming off of a narrow 2-1 loss against the Keller Indians. Had lots of scoring chances, but just could not capitalize on those chances as they almost defeated the number 5 team in the state, but came up short. Runner goes down to second. Throw down to second is not in time. That gets past Andrew Zahar over at second base. And Dupree reaches second on that stolen base. Lineups for the Lions coming up after this pitch from Duggar comes in. Count at 1-0 to Johnson. Duggar has his sign from Shearer, who's behind the plate. And this pitch comes in. That's fouled down the third base line. Brings the count even at 1-1. Jake Dupree just on second base. Bryce Johnson up to the plate. Seth Cox batting in the 3-hole. He'll be playing first base. He'll be followed by Sidney Ward. Tyler Townsend in the 5-hole. Followed by Aiden Escalante. Landon Kirkmaz in the 7-hole, followed by Josh Roloff, and Nathan Baker will be bringing things up in the 9-hole, and Baker will be the catcher for the Lions. Count at 2-1 now to Johnson. As Duggar gets his sign from Shearer, and we're just about ready to go. Dougie Fresh comes home. Ball gets away from Shearer. That goes a little wide, and Dupree reaches third now. Lions with an early chance to score, and Coach Yoder going to head on out, have a little talk with his infield. Today's Scott's baseball game is brought to you by Vista Bank. That is Vista Bank, entrepreneurs, banking entrepreneurs since 1912. And going around the horn for the Scots here, we have Harrison Duggar on the mound, and then Henry Shearer behind the plate. Krause at third, Preston Gamster over at short, Andrew Zahar at second, and then Rich at first. That is Jack Rich at first base. Turner in left, Braden Jirovec in center, and Jack Curtis will be in right field for the Scots today. Count at 3-1 to Johnson. And the Lions just coming off of their second game as that pitch comes in for strike two. Brings the count to full. Lions just finished up a game against the Keller Indians as well. Had the lead up until the seventh inning where the Indians ended up scoring a few runs and took an 8-6 win over the Lions. Ball gets passed on that ball four. No runner will go as Dupree stays at third. But now Johnson into first with a walk. Still nobody out. Runners on the corners now. Still very good position for the Lions. Chance to take the lead very early in today's game. Good stop there by Shearer. Runner advances to second. Johnson now at second base. For those of y'all that were with us last game, talked very early in that game about foul ball going, hitting my car very early on in the game. That ball ended up cracking my windshield, almost shattering it. So a little bit of bad luck for me on this Thursday afternoon. Also got word later in the game that just ended between the Indians and the Lions that an innocent driver ended up getting her windshield shattered as well. So a couple of accidents on this day one of the Scotland Yard tournament. Count at 2-0. Duggar comes home. Ball misses just outside for ball three. 3-0 now the count for Cox. Cox is the first baseman for the Lions tonight. That 3-0 pitch misses down low for ball four. Four-pitch walk that'll load the bases up for Sydney Ward. Bases are loaded, nobody out. Scott's in an early pickle as they're looking for their first out of the game. And Shearer going to head on out and have a little talk with Duggar, and he'll head back. And we're just about ready to get back to action. Infield fly rule in effect with nobody out. First pitch comes in. That's a called strike, bringing the count to 0-1 to Ward. Tyler Townsend currently on deck. Townsend will be on the mound for the Lions in today's matchup. Here's the 0-1 pitch. Misses down low and outside. That'll even the count up at 1-1. One and one the count. That is a high fly into center field. Jirovec going to come under that one. Runner will advance from third. Throw at the plate is not in time, and the Lions take an early 1-0 lead here in the top of the first. That's Jake Dupree showing off his wheels, getting home from third. Both Johnson and Cox will stay at second and first, and Sydney Ward is the first out after that F8 putout. That brings Tyler Townsend up to the plate.
Pitcher Tyler Townsend.
Duggar standing at 6'2", 170 pounds, big senior captain for this Scots team. Likes what he sees from Shearer. Here we go. Both runners go. Double steal. Throw down to second. Is not in time. That toe tag. Not in time, as that was Cox just getting his hand in the bag. And Johnson heads over to third now. Oh, one count. Ball misses outside. Evens at 1-1 to the pitcher. Townsend again on the mound in today's matchup. This is the 4 o'clock matchup. We have one more game at 6:30. Should have one more game at least. count 2-1 now. Harrison Duggar, going back to the deserted island question, what would you take with you on a deserted island? Duggar said Bear Grylls. For those of y'all who are familiar with Bear Grylls, he used to host an outdoor show. I believe it was Man vs. Wild. Swung on and missed for strike two. Brings the count even. 2 balls and 2 strikes with 1 away. Once again, runners on 2nd and 3rd. Cox with a good lead over at 2nd. No one holding him on. A ball chopped, and that will be fair. Picked up by Shear. Throw to 1st is in time for the 2nd out. 1 run will score as Johnson comes in from 3rd on that play. Cox heads over to 3rd, and Townsend will be out with that 2-3 putout. Brings Aiden Escalante up to the plate. Escalante, the designated hitter, he will not be in the field in today's game. Ball chopped foul towards the Lion dugout. Brings the count to 0-1, 2 away.
Designated hitter, Aiden Escalante.
A couple of new faces for the Scots today. A couple of players did not play this morning as Duggar comes home. That's lifted in to left field. That'll drop in front of Patrick Turner. That'll score another run on that two-out single from Aiden Escalante. So the Lions with an early 3-0 lead. And with two away, brings Landon Kirkmaz up to the plate. As I mentioned earlier, a couple of Scots new players as they did not play this morning. Shear did not play. Kraus and Zahar also did not play this morning. Landon Kirkmaz faces a 1-1 count. He'll be playing in center field for the Lions this evening. 0-1 pitch. Missing just on the outside. Brings the count to 2-1. Duggar, the pitcher slash outfielder, as I mentioned earlier, played left field in this morning's matchup. Now on the mound. Big swing and a miss there from Kirkmaz. That'll even the count at 2-2 now. Scott's looking for that 3rd out to stop the bleeding here in the top of the 1st. 2-2 pitch. Big swing and a miss, and he got him. Kirkmaz goes down with a strikeout. That is the 1st strikeout for Harrison Duggar. And that'll end the top half of the 1st. Lions with a 3-0 lead midway through 1. You're watching Highland Park Baseball on Game On Sports. bottom half of the first inning coming up here from Scotland Yard, 2021 Scotland Yard Classic. Highland Park Scots playing the McKinney High School Lions as the Scots getting their first at-bat of the day. And Braden Jurevic going to take the first crack at Tyler Townsend. As Townsend, already with a 1-0 count, misses that one for ball two. Jurevic with a 2-0 count. And Townsend comes home, misses down low for ball three. Jurevic way ahead in the count. Probably a hard red light here from the Scots center fielder. Count goes to 3-1. Hitter's count coming up to Jurevic. Jurevic played in this morning's game against Keller. As this pitch comes in, that's chopped down to third. That'll be picked up by Johnson. He'll throw it over to first for the first out. Jurevic goes down with that 5-3 putout, and that'll bring up Patrick Turner.
Left fielder, Patrick Turner.
Turner played right field in this morning's matchup, taking a little switch. He'll be playing left field this afternoon. Turn off. A little bit of a loud volume here on the field. I apologize. I forgot to mute my mic beforehand. Ball lifted high into foul territory, and that will drop as Turner now with an 0-1 count. A little bit of excitement here in that bottom half of the first. Turner, one of the senior leaders for this Scots team, mainly an outfielder, also plays at first base. 0-1. Ball misses down low for ball one. When he's not playing baseball, Patrick enjoys golf, fishing, and hunting. And he would also, he thinks that he would be voted most likely to hit a home run. He has one under his belt. That was a big grand slam last weekend. As that is a high fly ball into left field, back nearing the wall. And that'll be caught by Dupree. Long fly, just a couple of feet from going over the fence. Goes down as an F7. That brings Preston Gamster up to the plate. Gamster also played shortstop this afternoon. Ended 0-4 in this afternoon in this morning's game. And with two away, this first pitch misses down low for ball one. Gamster at short, Hunter Kraus currently on deck. That ball skied into foul territory over towards the first baseline. That'll be caught, and that was Ward making that grab for the third out. Scots go down quietly. No runs, no hits, no errors, and none left on base. After one full inning of play, Lions lead 3-0. Second inning of action coming up here from Scotland Yard, the 2021 Scotland Yard Classic. Day one is almost done here from Highland Park, Texas, as the Scots ready for their final game of the day, heading into the top of the second. McKinney Lions leading 3-0 after one inning of play. Went through a big inning as they scored three runs on only one hit. Lots of walks. The first three batters ended up getting walked. Dupree got hit by a pitch, and then Johnson and Cox both reached on balls. As we start this second inning, Josh Roloff will start things off, followed by Nathan Baker, the nine hole, and Jake Dupree will be back up in the hole. As this ball is ripped past second base for a base hit, that'll be picked up by Jurevec. And that's going to be a leadoff single for Josh Roloff. And the Lions pick up right where they left off, already with a runner on first. And that brings Nathan Baker up to the plate now.
Nathan Baker.
Baker behind the dish for the Lions here tonight. As Duggar prepares this first pitch, here he comes. Misses up high. Throw down to first. Not in time. You know, I don't know about that one. Coach Yoder going to head on out to the mound. Kind of looked like Baker kind of leaned his leg into that one. A little controversial, if you ask me. But the home plate umpire says you can take first base. And that will do it for Harrison Duggar. And we'll have a pitching change. We're going to take a little bit of a break as we have a runner on first, nobody out. And Scott's trail, 3-0.
Pitching for the Scots, number 7, Jack Jackson.
We did have a pitching change early in this second inning, as now on the mound for the Scots, number 7, Jack Jackson, the senior. Jackson, also an infielder, as he ended up playing third base in this morning's matchup, now taking the mound in relief of Harrison Duggar. Back up to the plate, Jake Dupree now in for his second at-bat. He got hit by a pitch to start things off back in the top of the first inning. Bunt laid down back towards the pitcher mound. Tried to bare hand by Jackson. Throw to first. Gets past Zahar. And that'll score another run on that pass ball, as Roloff comes in from second, score a run. Baker now into third. Jake Dupree into second on that And that's going to be an E1. A barehanded attempt from Johnson, or excuse me, Jackson, just could not handle it, and that caused him to rush the throw a bit, and everything just went haywire from there. 0-1 now the count to Bryce Johnson after that big swing and a miss from the Lions third baseman. Jackson standing at 6'3", 175 pounds. As that ball comes in a little too far inside for ball one. Once again, the Scots' first home games today and tomorrow. As we're finishing up this first day, they'll have two games tomorrow. That'll be at 11 a.m. and 6:30 p.m. as this ball heads back towards the wall. That is gone. An opposite field home run for Bryce Johnson, a three-run shot. Makes this a 7-0 game in favor of the Lions. And everything seems to be going right for this Lions team as they quickly out to a massive 7-0 lead. Scots have quite a bit of ground to make up. This ball hit for a base hit. That's just past Gamster. And with nobody out, runner on first brings Seth Cox up to the plate now. Excuse me, that is a Sydney Ward. Seth Cox now sits on first base. Jack Jackson, favorite player, Alex Bregman. Dreams of a major in business or sports broadcasting, and he hopes to work for ESPN one day. Cox a little slow to get up over at second base. Has to walk that off a little bit. Hope he's okay. He seems to be okay. As we're just about ready to get back to action, Jack Jackson now on the mound, as I mentioned earlier. 1-1 the count, nobody out. That's a skyrocket lifted past third base towards the fence. And that'll be brought in by Hunter Krause for that first out. Great job by the third baseman being sure, tracking that ball. That was a moonshot up the elevator shaft, so to speak. That took quite a while to come down.
Pitcher Tyler Townsend.
Ward down with an F5 for the finally first out of this top of the second inning. Scots trailing 7-0. The Lions brought in four runs before the Scots could get that first out. As this throw to second, quick tag from Gamster, not in time. And Cox going to stay at second base. Tyler Townsend, 0-for-1 so far. He had a ground out back in the first. Ball in the dirt. Shear making sure to get in front of that. Good effort there from the battery. Count 1-0 to Townsend. Townsend having a good day at the plate or at the mound so far in this game. Went 1-2-3 back in the bottom half of the first. Jackson, fun fact, not the first Jackson to play under Coach Yoder. He actually had an older brother that also played under Coach Yoder in previous years. Count goes to 2-0 now to Tyler Townsend. As this pitch misses for another ball, should make it 3-0. Throw over to second. Again, not in time. Cox this time in standing up. Didn't have to dive back. Could probably afford to get a couple extra steps there at second base. Two and oh, nobody out. Or excuse me, one out as that is lifted just past shortstop, and Gamster is going to make up that grab. And that'll bring two away for Aiden Escalante. Escalante already has a single under his belt as he steps in, digs into the box for his second at-bat of the game. That first pitch misses up high. Count at 1-0 to Escalante. Jackson's baseball superstition, don't step on the foul line, much like a lot of these Scots players. A lot of superstitions, don't step on the foul line. That's probably the most common superstition in baseball. Very bad omen if you step on any of the foul lines coming to or from the field. 1-0, two-away, runner goes, and that is fouled off. That evens the count, 1-1. With this at-bat from Escalante, Landon Kirkmaz, who's on deck, the only remaining Lion without an at-bat in this inning. That's a called strike. Brings the count to 1-2 to Escalante. Another big crowd in today's game, both Highland Park fans and McKinney fans alike coming out to watch this game, as this is a rocket just over second base, and that'll be picked up by Gamster once again for the third out. Scots finally get out of that inning, but not before the Lions rack up some runs, adding on to their lead, now leading 7-0 over the Scots midway through two. We'll be right back for the bottom of the second. You're watching Highland Park Baseball on Game On Sports. Back up for the bottom of the second inning. Scots getting their second at-bat of the day. Hunter Krause will start things off. He'll be followed by Harrison Duggar, and Jack Curtis will be in the hole. and Tyler Townsend back on the mound to deal in this second inning. Count at 1-0 to Kraus. Kraus, the 5'9 senior. That's a rip fouled down the third base line. Brings the count even at 1-1. Kraus did not play this morning. His is his first game of the weekend. Townsend misses up high for ball two. Kraus, the third baseman slash pitcher, playing at third base in today's game, says the team goal for 2021 is to win district. Would be quite an achievement for this Scott's ball team. 3-1 the count. Townsend delivers. That's lifted over shortstop. That is in to left center field for a base hit. Kraus heading to second. Play at second will not come in. And Kraus in with a double to start things off. The first base hit for the Scots as Kraus slides into second for a leadoff double. That brings Harrison Duggar up to the plate.
At the plate, pitcher Jack Jackson.
Oh, excuse me, that is Jack Jackson now at the plate. Jackson taking over for Duggar after that pitching change last half inning. This is Jackson's first at-bat of the game. He did play this morning and did 0-for-1, only had one registered at-bat. He did reach a base twice with two walks, and he also reached home once. The Scots lone run this morning. Count now at 3-0 to Jackson, the senior pitcher and infielder. Throw over to second is not in time. Good effort from Kraus getting back just before that tag could be put down. And a 4-pitch walk to Jackson will bring runners to first and second. Infield fly rule will go into effect. Nobody out for Jack Curtis now.
Right fielder, Jack Curtis.
Curtis in right field. After not playing in the field in last game, he ended as the designated hitter. Also went 0-for-1 with a couple of walks, and he struck out in the fourth. That strikeout was his only at bat of the game. Adam Rourke subs in as a pinch runner now for Jackson. It's that courtesy runner. Rourke also ran a bit last game, showing off that 4-4 40-yard dash time. Only a sophomore dual sport athlete playing varsity football for the Scots as well. That breaking ball misses outside just off the back door. Evens the count 1-1 now to Curtis. Curtis, the junior, sort of a utility player. As this ball hit over past short, that'll go through for a base hit. That could score a run. That's going to be Kraus heading in. And he will score. And the Scots find themselves on the board now as Jackson heads into third. Curtis now into second. That'll bring Henry Shearer up to the plate now. Shearer.
Catcher Henry Shearer.
The battery for the Scots in today's game. Called strike to start things off with an 0-1 count. Two runners in scoring position now. The Scots starting to make their way back slowly but surely. Down 7-1 now. Ball count evened at 1-1 after that ball missed. Down low. Shearer the junior, standing at 5'8", 155 pounds. Only plays catcher. Shearer and Bowers both gotten about equal time behind the plate this season, usually switching off between games. Three and one, the hitters count on the way to Shearer. He can expect a fastball coming in from Townsend in this pitch. Fastball on the inside corner brings the count to full at 3-2. Still nobody out, runners on second and third. And Andrew Zahar on deck. That is ball four, misses down low. And Shearer into first now, and that will load the bases up. Zahar getting his first action of the day. Did not play this morning. And now Sam Sessions into run for Shearer over at first.
Now running first base, number 6, Sam Sessions.
Zahar, the senior infielder, once again, did not play this morning. This is his very first at-bat of the weekend. 0-1 count. Ball gets away. Runner goes from home. Play at the plate. It is not in time. Baker tried to flip it. Could not get it in time. And the Scots now trail 7-2. Jackson coming in. Excuse me, that was Rourke coming in from third. And with nobody out, the Scots only 5 runs down now. 1-1, that ball is stopped by Baker. Baker lunging over to his left to get in front of that one. Zahar facing a 2-1 count now. Now, Ryan Grosser. That's Gross, excuse me, Ryan Gross, going to head on out, have a little talk with Townsend and Baker. Once again, Scotland Yard Classic, the Scots and the Lions, 2 of 6 teams in this year's Scotland Yard Classic, along with the Prosper Eagles, the Keller Indians, the Saxey Mustangs, and the McKinney Boyd Broncos. Two one pitch from Zahar is fouled off. Is that evens the count at 2-2? The Scots come back tomorrow. They'll be playing the Mustangs, Saxey Mustangs, and the McKinney Boyd Broncos. That'll be tomorrow. Once again, they'll be here on Game On Sports. And Zahar goes down with a strikeout. So that's a backwards K for Zahar, and now Jack Rich steps up to the plate.
First baseman Jack Rich.
Rich, the first baseman, watches that one go inside, almost hitting him near the hip. That brings the count to 1-0. Zahar, the first out of this bottom of the second. Scott's looking to continue their big inning here. Rich, nicknamed Mantis, standing at 6'5", 200 pounds. That's a high drive into left field, back towards the warning track, at the wall for the catch. That is gone. A three-run shot for Jack Rich. And just like that, the Scots inching their way closer as they now trail 7-5 after that three-run bomb. And you can hear the excitement from that Scots crowd as it looked like the Lions were just going to keep running away with this game, but the Scots have had themselves a huge inning, scoring 5 runs. The Scots have been known for big innings here in the past couple of weekends, a couple of 4-run innings, some 6-run innings as well. They had that big 11-4 win over the Denton Broncos last weekend where they had a 6-run inning with a couple of home runs. Ball chopped towards short. That'll be picked up by Roloff. He'll toss it over to first for the second out. And that was Jurevec going down. He is now 0-2 with that 6-3 putout. And that brings Patrick Turner up to the plate. Turner at 0-1 as well. He had a flyout. And that was back last inning. Once again, we're still only in the second inning of play. A couple of long innings from both teams. And that's a high drive once again into left field. Back nearing the warning track. And that will be brought in by Dupree. Couple of long flies there from Turner as both went to the warning track. He is just a couple of feet from getting his first bomb. But the Scots go down, not before adding a few runs to their score. Now trailing only 7-5 after 2 innings of play. You're watching Game On Sports. Top of the third coming up from Scotland Yard. Scots going against the McKinney Lions. The Lions with a 7-5 lead. Got that 7-run lead in the top of the second. And then the Scots came back and battled with a 5-run inning. That is a big first hack there from Landon Kirkmaz to start things off with an 0-1 count. Now we have ourselves a baseball game now. Kirkmaz in the left-handed box. Jackson back on the mound. As that one fouled off. And that will be bring the count to 0-2 now. After last game, ended up moving my car just in the direction of where that foul ball was hit. I'm hoping that that did not hit it for the second time today. Very unlucky if it would. That 0-2 pitch misses up high and outside for ball one. Jackson still ahead in the count. Possibly a breaking ball here on this pitch coming up to Kirkmaz. Fastball called. Strike 3 outside corner. He got him looking. Kirkmaz goes down to 0-2. Pair of strikeouts so far for him today. And that'll bring Josh Roloff up to the plate. Roloff 1-for-1 with a single back in the second inning. Started things off with a single. Ended up reaching home And that started that huge four-run inning for the Lions. Both Jackson with one strikeout. Duggar, who only saw one full inning of action, he got taken out in the top of the second as that one hit over towards the third baseline. Foul as that almost hitting a pickup. And I've just been told it did hit the pickup. No cracks as looks like it hit the hood. Very dangerous for drivers who could be unaware of the foul balls coming in from Scotland Yard. Scotland Yard built right next to the indoor facility that you see out in left and center field. Center field actually, in the background, the new natatorium just built last year for Highland Park Swimming and Diving. That ball lifted into center field. That'll be Jurevec ranging back. That goes off of his glove. And that's going to be Roloff heading to third. Play at third base is not in time. A little bit of a celebration there as Roloff into third after that long fly. I'm not going to put that as an error for Jurevec, even though it did touch his glove. That is in no way a routine play. Heading back towards the wall, had to try to make that grab over his shoulder. Not an easy play to make.
Catcher, Nathan Baker.
And that's going to bring Nathan Baker up to the plate. Runner on third with one away. Baker, the catcher, got hit by a pitch in his last at bat. Bunt is shown, cannot make contact. Throw back over to third. That gets past Johnson. That gets past Kraus, actually. And Roloff jogs his way home from third. And the Lions now with an 8-5 lead. Shearer with a good idea could have had a close play there for an out, but instead threw it just over the head of Kraus and sent that ball zooming into left field. Coach Yoder going to head on out, have a quick talk with his infield, just make sure they're all on the same page before he heads back into the dugout. Baker back at the plate with a big swing and a miss. And that's 0-2 now. And Jake Dupree awaiting his third at bat on deck. Third plate appearance. No at bats so far for Dupree. And this is Baker's second plate appearance. No at bats for him either, as he ended up reaching base and ended up reaching home later on in that at bat. 1-2 the count. Here's the pitch. Ball is fouled off. Keeps the count 1-2 with one away. Jack Jackson, when he's not playing baseball, loves to play golf and also loves fishing. Big fisherman. Called strike three, and that is the second out of this third inning. No runners on as Jake Dupree now steps up to the plate.
Left fielder Jake Dupree.
I apologize. That is Dupree. I was not aware I said Dupree for that little amount of time there. Two away, no runners on.
Yeah,
Brings the count 0-2 with two away. That's a high drive into left field. It's going to be Patrick Turner making the grab. And that'll end the top half of the third. The Lions add a run, now leading 8-5. But the Scots, after a five-run inning in the second, hoping to add more runs and possibly take a lead later on in the game. Stay with us. You're watching Game On Sports. Back for the bottom of the third inning from Scotland Yard, Highland Park Scots taking on the McKinney Lions. Do it for the Scots. Going to be Preston Gamster, Hunter Krause, and Jack Jackson in the hole. Start things off in this bottom of the third. Scots are trailing 8-5 after a huge inning back in the second. Krause currently, Gamster actually, as he is currently at 0-1. Is that evens the count at 1-1 now? Gamster also played in this morning's game where he ended up 0-4 with a strikeout, flyout, and a groundout. And he also ended with a flyout, infield flyout to end the game. Two and two, here's the pitch. That is ripped past third base for a base hit. And that is passed to diving Johnson. That'll be a leadoff single for Preston Gamster. Scots keep the bats rolling as now Hunter Krause up to the plate. Krause, the third baseman, digging in, had a double in his last at-bat, started things off for the Scots. Ended up reaching home as well, the first of five runs in that inning. Scots had a very impressive game this morning, facing number five team Keller, the Keller Indians, number five in the state for Class 6A. Scots had a lot of opportunities to take the lead and an opportunity to win the game at the end, but just could not capitalize on those runners as they all got left stranded. A bunch of runners on third and second got stranded, and they just could not come up with any more runs. And they came down with a 2-1 loss against the Indians this morning. 1-1, the pitch straight up. That's going to be in the infield, and that's going to be brought in and dropped. Not sure what's happening. Nobody knows what's happening. Krause standing on first. And that's finally going to be a foul ball. I did not see where that ball went. Not sure what happened. And they're going to call Krause out. That ball ended up going into the glove of Roloff and then bouncing out because both runners were on first at the same time. They're going to call Kraus out. Gamster back on first.
Great pitcher, Jackson.
Jack Jackson now up at the plate. Jackson ended with a walk in that last inning. Harrison Duggar, who started out the game, did not end up getting an at-bat as he left the game just before he was due up. 0-2 the count now to Jackson, who reached on a walk in his last at-bat. Breaking ball, he got him looking. So Jackson goes down with a strikeout, and that brings Jack Curtis now up to the plate. Curtis, the right fielder in today's action. Curtis at 6'4", 225 pounds, just a junior. Just a massive ball player, also plays football for the Scots, as he has quite a few offers for football, offers from the Air Force Academy as well as the Army at West Point. San Diego State, Arizona, Lehigh, and Columbia have all offered Curtis. He's not sure where he wants to go yet, but based on those schools, he wants to play football as well as major in either pre-med or business. Want to know the count to Curtis. Pitch comes in up high and outside for ball two. Two away, runner on first. Gamster with a good lead over at first base. Looks to be about 7 or 8 feet. This pitch is fouled off. Could hit a car. Nope, that will land on Lover's Lane and bounce into the neighboring houses. One of the neighboring houses across the street. Heard a little story from Coach Yoder actually last weekend. Whenever foul balls end up going into those neighboring houses at Scotland Yard, he has to send players sprinting and dodging, basically heading across the street to try to grab those balls from those houses before the neighbors grab them and sometimes try to take those foul balls and keep them for themselves. So it's a little bit of a race from those players trying to grab those foul balls. 2-2 the count, two away. The hats are shaking here at Scotland Yard. And here's the pitch. That's a chopped ball over towards third. That could be trouble, and there will be no throw. Throw over to second, not in time. That was Johnson, who was way back past third base. And that ball, slow chopping roller down towards third, just could not get to it in time. So runners now on first and second with two away. After that infield single. And that'll bring Henry Shearer up to the plate.
Catcher Henry Shearer.
Shearer, the junior, has a favorite MLB player. You don't hear much anymore. His favorite MLB player, Paul Konerko. Usually you hear someone say a couple players for the Scots. Clayton Kershaw, for example. Kershaw, former Highland Park grad, also former NL MVP and NL Cy Young winner as well. Arguably a MLB Hall of Famer, Clayton Kershaw. 2-0 the count now. Shearer in the left-handed box. Or excuse me, that is right-handed, actually. Box facing my left, but it is the right-handed box. Brings the count to 2-1 with two away. Lions looking to get out of this inning without allowing an extra run. Still holding on to that 8-5 lead. Townsend comes home. Big swing and a big miss from Shearer. Bringing the count now to 2-2. The hat shaking once again here in Highland Park. Here's a pitch from Townsend. Breaking ball just low. Brings the count to full at 3-2. Very close pitch there from Townsend. Shearer with the great eye. As that one just missing the strike zone. The payoff pitch coming up from Townsend. Both runners go. High cheese. He got him swinging. Shearer goes down to 0-1 after that strikeout to end that third inning. And the Scots trail 8-5 after 3. We'll be right back. You're watching Game On Sports. Top half of the fourth inning, Scott's trailing 8-5 as we are just about to get ready back for action. Jackson brings this one home, and that misses somewhere. Not sure where that missed. That looked like a perfect pitch as Bryce Johnson is now at the plate. Johnson 1-for-1 as this ball is lifted into left field, and that will be slid on and caught. As we have a couple of substitutions here for the Scots, that looks like Patrick Turner now out in center. So Turner now in center. Let's see who is out in left field. That looks to be Pete McCon. And that is Pete McCon out in left field. So Braden Jirovec has subbed out of the game. Hope he's okay. Hopefully not due to injury. That should be the only substitutions of the game so far. Two and 0, one away. That is a called strike on the outside corner. Bringing the count to 2-1. We'll head over towards third. That'll be picked up by Krause. He bobbled it a little bit. Throw to first is not in time. Dove for that ball, had a little trouble with it. Made sure to stop it and keep it from getting to the outfield. However, he could not get up in time to make that throw. And so that is going to be Bryce Johnson with a single to start things off. Again, I did not give Krause that error. Even though that did touch his glove, that was not a routine play. Had to try to dive to make that grab. First pitch just outside. My goodness. Missing by maybe an inch, maybe less. As Sidney Ward now at the plate. Count at 2-0. As Seth Cox sits on first base. It's a high drive into left field, and that's going to be picked up by McCon for that second out. McCon getting right down to business. Already two putouts in his first half inning. Runner goes from second, throw down from Shearer. Not in time. That went just a little too far over away from the bag for Zahar. Excuse me, that is Gamster. Zahar at second, Gamster at short. That's behind home plate towards the bleachers, landing just behind the bleachers. I think that might have stayed in the wall, actually. That one and one, two away. Jackson's favorite baseball memory at the time. Coach Yoder, as runner goes, no throw from Shearer. So saying earlier, Jackson's favorite baseball memory at the time Coach Yoder hit a ground ball so hard, once broke his glove. That doesn't happen every day. Yoder apparently with some fungo power. Jackson ready with this 2-1 pitch. Hit over towards short. That'll be picked up by Gamster. Backhanded. Throw to first. Is in time. That will end the top half of the fourth inning. And the Lions will go down. No runs on one hit. No errors. And one left on base. Seth Cox stranded. Scott's coming back up for the bottom of the fourth. Trailing 8-5. You're watching Highland Park Baseball on Game On Sports. Bottom half of the fourth inning from Scotland Yard. Scott's trailing 8-5 heading into the bottom of the fourth inning. We have another substitution now, as Andrew Zahar has now been subbed out by Sam Sessions. So Sessions will now come in to hit for Zahar. So Zahar ends his day 0-for-1. He strikes out looking. And it looks like Sessions will also take over at second. Ball is a called strike, brings the count even at 1-1. Sessions played this morning. He ended 0-for-3 with a couple of flyouts and also a ground out. That ball gets past Baker, brings the count to 2-1. That's lifted towards center field. Could be trouble. Sliding grab by Kirkmaz, and he will make the grab for that first out. Sessions goes down with that F8, and that brings Jack Rich now to the plate.
First baseman, Jack Rich.
Rich, one of the big players for the Scots, 6'5", 200 pounds, only a junior, nicknamed Mantis. Favorite MLB player, Joey Gallo, power hitter for the Texas Rangers. That evens the count 1-1 now to Rich. Thank you. I apologize, not sure why I'm sneezing so much. People from the stands can hear me. I apologize to everybody. 2-1 the count with one away. Yeah, I think the PA might still be on. Seems the whole stadium can hear me. 3-1 the count. The hitter's count coming up to Rich. Rich, the first baseman. Pitch comes in. That's a high drive. And that'll be trouble. That'll be dropped by the combo. Play at second. Not in time. Jack Rich in with a double. That combination of Dupre and Roloff could not make the grab. Roloff running in all the way from short trying to make that grab. Could not do it. As Jack Rich will start in with a one-out double. And that'll bring up Pete McCon. Once again, McCon now in for Braden Jirovec at center. And that hits him. And that's a good start there for Pete McCon. McCon also the left fielder, not the center fielder. So runners on first and second, only one away for Patrick Turner. Turner, the 2019 District Offensive Player of the Year, also received All-American honors, and that was last season, that cutoff season, where they only played 12 games. Patrick Turner actually had 5 home runs in that 12-game span. It means that 31% of the time, 31% of his hits were home runs. Turner with 1 home run so far this season, that grand slam against Denton. That was last weekend at Prosper Rock Hill High School, and that's a rip down the third base line. That goes foul as that lands to the left of the line. Turner 0-for-2 so far. Two deep flies, both to left field, being caught right near the wall. Just a couple of feet from that first home run from Scotland Yard this season. Ball hit down third base. That is picked up. Third base stepped on by Johnson. He'll throw to first. That throw is not in time. So Turner reaches on a fielder's choice of sorts. As Johnson stepped on third for that second out. So runners now on first and second. Pete McCon in at second base. Preston Gamster up at the plate once again. Gamster 1-for-2 with a fly out in the first and a single in the second. Ended up reaching second base back in that actually third inning of play. One and oh now the count as Townsend comes set. He's ready to come home. Ball off the leg of Gamster. So he has to limp a little bit, get some feeling back in his foot. Could have a little bruise there for the next couple of days. Just about an hour and a half of game time so far in this game. It's about 5:50, a little past 5:50. Almost dinner time. Be sure, if you haven't had dinner or if you eat dinner around 6, 6:30, be sure to stop by Goff's Hamburgers, a tradition like no other. That 1-0 pitch misses up high. That's 1-1 as that evens the count. Also give a quick shout-out real quick to Chip's Old Fashioned Hamburgers, the best burger ever. I do have to say, it is quite a great burger. I actually went there in between games just a couple hours ago. Really great burger on a poppy seed bun with some exquisite fries and a pretty amazing chocolate shake as well. One and two the count with two away. Pitch from Townsend. Hit over to short, and that is going to be picked up by Roloff for the third out. So the Scots go down a couple of base runners, but could not capitalize on those runners as they go down no runs on one hit. That'll be one error, no errors, and two left on base. And we'll be back. Scots trailing 8-5 after four. Fifth inning coming up here from Scotland Yard, home of the Highland Park Scots. Scots in their second game of the day in this day one of the 2021 Scotland Yard Classic. Once again, you're listening to Scots Baseball, brought to you by Vista Bank. Vista Bank, people first. Scots going up against the McKinney Lions, who currently lead 8-5 in the top of the fifth inning now. Due up for the Lions, it's going to be Aiden Escalante. He'll be followed by Landon Kirkmaz. And Josh Roloff will be in the hole. Escalante with a hit and a flyout so far to his name. He had a base hit back in the first. This ball hit over towards second. And that's going to be picked up by Sessions. He'll toss it over to first for the first out. And Sessions, picking up right where he left off, had quite a few outs in that first game this morning. As the first five of six outs in that first game, four of six outs in that first game were thanks to Sam Sessions. So with one away, it brings Landon Kirkmaz up to the plate. Kirkmaz, the center fielder, 0 for 2 with a pair of strikeouts, one looking and one swinging so far to his name. Jackson misses that one a little bit low and outside. Evens the count at one ball and one strike. Also want to give a quick shout out real quick to Audi Dallas, the number one Texas Audi dealer. As this one is a rocket into center field. Patrick Turner sailing under it right in between the H and the P in center field. And that'll be quickly two away now for the Scots. Josh Roloff stepping up to the plate. Now Roloff 2 for 2 with a single and a triple. He has the hardest part of that cycle down, as, in my opinion, the triple, the hardest part of the cycle to hit for. Ball chopped over the pitcher's mound, picked up by Sessions, sliding grab over to first. What a play! Sam Sessions with an all-star level play to end that top half of the fifth inning, and the Lions go down quietly. No runs, no hits, no errors, none left on base. The Scots batting for the bottom. Bottom half of the fifth inning from Scotland Yard, home of the Highland Park Scots, as the sun starting to go down. We're getting towards sunset here in Highland Park High School. You see those lights coming on here at Scotland Yard. Scots trailing 8-5 in the bottom of the fifth inning. Due up for Highland Park, Hunter Krause will be followed by Jack Jackson, and Jack Curtis will be in the hole. Tyler Townsend on the mound once again, as Krause faces that 1-0 count. The Scots starting to run out of time here as they trail by 3 runs. Ball hit over into right left field. That is dove and caught. What a catch from Dupre. He has a couple of SportsCenter top 10 worthy catches in today's game. As that's one away for the Scots after that F7 put out. That brings Jack Jackson up to the plate. Jackson currently at 0-for-1. He had reached on a walk in his first at-bat and then had a strikeout. He struck out looking in the bottom of the third. Did reach home in the second. That was the first of 4 runs for the Scots. Second of 4 runs. Krause was the first one to reach after hitting a double. Jackson was the second. 1-1 the count, one away. Here's the pitch. breaking ball. Great strike there from Townsend. That brings the count to 1-2. You saw Jackson duck out of the way of that one. He thought it was going to hit him. Then dropped right into the strike zone. 1-2. Big swing and a miss from Jackson, and he'll go down swinging. So two strikeouts for the pitcher, and that brings Jack Curtis. Curtis, the big junior, up in the right-handed box, ready for his third at-bat. Curtis, 2-for-2, pair of singles so far to his name. That's a high drive into center field. Will get down for extra bases. That's in the right center gap. Curtis going to head for second. That will be a stand-up double for Jack Curtis. Maybe the start of a two-out rally as Henry Shearer going to step up to the plate. Shearer, the catcher, currently at 0-for-1. Reached on a walk in the second. Ended up reaching home later on in that inning and then had a strikeout in the third. So he is 0-for-1 with only one at-bat. Two plate appearances, though. Two away, the Lions looking to end this fifth inning without giving up any more runs and maintaining that three-run lead. Another breaking ball dropping right over the top of the strike zone for strike one. Shearer with an 0-1 count. As Townsend readies with the 0-1. Another breaking ball dropping in for strike two. Shearer says his favorite Highland Park baseball memory, running into Coop Nato during freshman year tryouts, and he will go down for the third out. Shearer goes down with a strikeout, now at 0-for-2, and that will end the fifth inning. Scots go down, no runs on one hit, no errors, and one left on base. Curtis stranded after that two-out double. Scots trail 8-5 through five. You're watching Game On Sports. Sixth inning of action coming up from Scotland Yard, home of the Highland Park Scots. Scots trailing 8-5 against the McKinney Lions. After a lot of scoring in those first three innings of play, we've had two straight of zeros put up on the board. As the count goes to 0-1 with nobody out. Due up for the Lions, Nathan Baker starting things off with an 0-2 count. And then he'll be followed by Jake Dupre and Bryce Johnson. Oh and two. Jackson, this ball hit back up the middle. That'll be picked up by Sessions. Hard throw over to first in time for that first out. Sam Sessions having himself a day. That first out of this sixth inning. one away now for Jake Dupre. Dupre, 0-for-1, despite having three plate appearances, got hit to start the top of the first, and then reached base on an error in the second, and then had that fly out in the third. Bunt laid down the third baseline. That is a perfectly laid bunt. That's going to be fair. That hits off of Kraut. No, umpire calls foul. As that was put down right by the first base, right down the third baseline, then all of a sudden rolled foul. Kind of looked like Kraus might have touched it, but the umpire calls it foul. And that will bring the count now to 0-1 with one away. Would have been a perfectly laid bunt, no doubt a single, because you can't get any more perfectly down the line than that bunt was. That 0-1 pitch drops in for strike two. And Jackson way ahead in the count now to Dupre. Look for that possibly breaking ball on this 0-2 pitch. One and two the count. That ball misses in the dirt. Still ahead here. 1-2 with one away. No runners on. Dupre, the left fielder. Jackson brings it home. Fouled off. Keeps the count at 1-2. Jackson, the senior, nicknamed Fargo and JJ. Fargo, very interesting nickname. JJ, of course, his initials. 1-2. Pitch misses up high for ball two. Ball ripped down the third baseline, just foul, as that goes just to the left of third base. Keeps the count at 2-2. Jackson's favorite Highland Park baseball memory, hitting a home run to Wells Fargo last year. And you see that Wells Fargo just out of right field across the street. Quite a long distance. So quite a big home run from Jackson last season. Ball hit into foul territory is that we run on by one of the McKinney Lions. Keeps the count 2-2 with one away. Good battle between Jackson and Dupre. Jackson delivers. Fastball hits straight up and landing just behind the crowd once again, bouncing into the bleachers. Net actually bounced behind the bleachers, hit off the wall, and jumped right back in. Scared a couple of fans, but no harm done. Jackson, the 6'3 senior, with the tie-breaking pitch, misses just outside, inside and low for ball three. Three and two, one away. Jackson with the pitch. Breaking ball. Called low. As Shearer was for sure that was strike three. Home plate umpire says no, that is low, and that is a full count walk for Jake Dupre. That brings Bryce Johnson now up to the plate. Johnson with that home run back in the second inning. That was a three-run shot. That helped the Lions get to that 8-5 lead. Johnson overall 1-for-2 with that home run. He had a fly out back in the fourth and then got walked in the third. Three plate appearances, only two at-bats. Throw to first once again. Again, not in time. Dupre, in very easily, still standing up, could afford to get a couple of extra steps. Here's the pitch. Runner goes. Shearer, throw down to second. Oh, my goodness. Sadly, though, that was a balk. Jackson, not sure what's happening. Home plate umpire says he did not come all the way set, moving that glove up and down. And so Dupre into second. Great throw there from Shearer. Just bad luck as that got called for the balk. So 1-0 the count to Johnson. That's a drive into center field. Patrick Turner ranging over, and that'll actually be brought in by Jack Curtis. Curtis coming into shallow right center field to make that grab. And with two away, brings Seth Cox up to the plate. Cox, the first baseman, with a pair of singles, 2 for 2. With those singles. He's reached second and third, but has not come home yet this game. That pair of singles, and then he got walked back in the first. One of those first three batters to be walked in this game. Jackson comes home. First pitch is a called strike. Brings the count to 0-1. Again, I do apologize. I think I scared some people up in the crowd. 0-1 the count with two away. And that one fouled off, bringing the count to 0-2 with two down. Cox very behind in the count now, as Jackson could do anything with this pitch. Jackson delivers, just missing on the outside corner for ball one. Take this moment to give a shout out to VentureX Dallas Park Cities, the future of workspace. Also want to give a shout out to Rimrock Partners. One and two. That's lifted. That'll stay in the infield. That'll be called on by Rich. He'll make the grab to end the inning. End of the top half of the sixth. The Lions go down. No runs on no hits, no errors, and one runner left on base. Scott's coming up to bat for their sixth inning of play, trailing 8-5.
For the Scots in the bottom of the sixth. Second baseman, Sam Sessions.
Bottom of the sixth inning coming up for the Scots. Due up, Sam Sessions. He'll be followed by Jack Rich and Pete McCon will be in the hole. Sam Sessions hitting for Andrew Zahar. He subbed in for Zahar back in the fourth inning. Is that first pitch fouled off down towards the Scots dugout, and that will bring the count to 0-1. Scots trailing 8-5 against the McKinney Lions. Looking to get that first win of the Scotland Yard Classic. 0-1 after a 2-1 loss over the Keller Indians earlier on today. Ball head over towards third. That'll be picked up by Johnson. He'll make the throw over to first in time for that first out. So Sessions with a 5-3 putout to start things off, and that'll bring up Jack Rich. Rich with a great day at the plate so far. 2-for-2 with a home run and a double. That home run over the left field fence during that big 5-run inning for the Scots. The ball misses inside for ball one. Pitch in from Townsend. Evens the count, 1-1 now. Rich looking to be the first base runner of this sixth inning for the Scots. Scots with just two chances left, this inning and then the seventh coming up. Breaking ball on the back door, missing just outside. Brings the count even at 2-2. Rich swings and misses that one. Drop third strike. That gets past Baker. And Rich will reach first base on that drop third strike. And that'll bring Pete McCon up to the plate now. You know, it's times like those when you got to love that drop third strike rule. You only like that rule when you're on offense. McCon, and for his second at-bat, he got hit with a pitch last time up. Pitch from Townsend misses inside for ball one. McCon standing at 6'2", 175 pounds as a junior. Lots of tall, well-built players on this Scots baseball team. 1-1 the count, one away. Scots trailing 8-5. Not a full swing there for McCon. I feel like he wanted to check swing, but just could not bring it back in time. Brings the count to 1-2. That 1-2 ball misses down low for ball two. Evening the count with one away. Runner on first. The Scots looking to have another big inning here. Hopefully take that lead that they need to go 1-1 on the day. One, two. That's the pitch. Hit over to short. That'll be picked up by Roloff. He'll step on second. Throw to first is in time. What a play from Roloff. As he showboats a bit on his way to the dugout, that'll go down as a 6-3 double play. And that'll end the sixth inning. Last frame coming up. Scots trail 8-5. You're watching Game On Sports. Thank you. Last inning of action coming up here from Highland Park High School, Scotland Yard, home of the 2021 Scotland Yard Classic. Jackson back on the mound for the Scots as this first pitch comes into Sydney Ward for strike one. Ward starting things off. He'll be followed by Tyler Townsend, and Aiden Escalante will be in the hole. So far, no subs for the Lions, as they haven't even had a pitching change so far today. One and one the count. Here's the pitch. Misses up high for ball two. Ward currently at 0 for 3 with three flyouts to center field, third base, and left field. As that ball gets away in the dirt, Shearer blocks it, and that brings the count to 3-1. Hitter's count coming up to Ward, who can almost expect a fastball coming up from Jackson. The right-hander deals that fastball on the inside part of the plate, brings the count to full, 3-2. Townsend, pitcher for the Lions, currently on deck, also 0 for 3 with a couple of groundouts and a flyout. That 3-2 pitch is fouled as that goes into the street. Keeps the count full now to Ward. Ward, the right fielder for the Lions here tonight. Once again, the Scots back in action. That'll be tomorrow for two games at 11 and 6:30. That ball in foul territory over by third. That'll be picked up by Krause for that first out of the inning. Ward goes down after a battle with an F5 putout. Townsend now up to the plate. Townsend, the pitcher, as I mentioned, 0 for 3 so far tonight, looking for that first hit of the game. One and 0 the count to Townsend as Jackson comes home, misses for ball two. Brings the count to 2-0. Here's the pitch from Jackson. That's fouled off as that goes down the first third baseline just over the Scots dugout, bringing the count to 2-1. Jackson, favorite TV show, The 100. Also a fan of root beer. This ball hit over to second. Gets away from Rich. That'll go down as an E4 from Sessions. Sessions with his first error of the day as Townsend now on first. Escalante, the DH, now up at the plate. 1 for 3 with a single, a flyout, and a groundout. Ball fouled off to start things off, bringing the count to 0-1. A beautiful Thursday evening here from Highland Park. A little cloudy, but no rain so far today. Hopefully that'll continue into the weekend. Little chance of rain here for the weekend, but as far as I know, it's fairly low, only in the 40s and 50s Highlander Stadium, the football stadium for the Scots, lit up behind the left field fence. Maybe a soccer game going on tonight. Ball misses up high for ball one. Count evens, 2-2, one away. Runner on first. The Scots looking to get out of this inning and go bat. That last frame coming up here right after this. Jackson steps off, regathers himself, and then steps right back on. We're ready to go. Pitch misses up high, bringing the count full. 3 balls and 2 strikes. Jackson with a 3-2. That low pitch is fouled off. That'll keep the count full, 3-2. Jackson thinks he would be voted most likely to get into a wreck driving to the game. I sure would hope that doesn't happen, but he thinks it would be likely. 3-2, one away. Ball misses down low for ball four. Runners now at first and second. Townsend heads to second base. Escalante now into first. Krause is going to have a little talk with Jack Jackson. And Landon Kirkmaz is going to step up to the plate. Kirkmaz at 0-for-3 with a pair of strikeouts and a flyout so far to his name. Stepping into the left-handed box, and we're almost ready to go. Jackson likes what he sees from Shearer. Throw to first, trick play, unsuccessful. That fake bunt play, bunt coverage, that the Scots have put into play quite a few times over the past couple of weekends. It's worked a few times, but also has not worked a few times as well. Big swing and a miss there from Kirkmaz. He has an 0-1 count. Ball misses outside. Evens the count 1-1. Due up for the Scots when we return for the bottom of the seventh. And that will be Pete McCon, followed by Patrick Turner and Preston Gamster. Excuse me, that will not be Pete McCon. That'll be Patrick Turner starting things off as this one's lifted into left field. That'll be brought in by McCon for that second out. So Pete McCon ended the sixth inning with that 6-3 double play. That means Patrick Turner will start things off, followed by Preston Gamster and Hunter Krause. And that'll be the bottom of the seventh inning when we come back. Josh Roloff now up to the plate. Roloff with a single and a triple, as well as a ground out in today's game. Time is called, time is given. As Jackson comes home, hit right back up the middle, and caught! My goodness! What a grab from Jack Jackson, flashing the leather there. And that hot line drive just brought in great reflexes, or pure luck, you might say. We're calling it great reflexes, as that looked like it had some pure skill on that line drive. Coming up, bottom of the seventh, last chance for the Scots, trailing 8-5. You're watching Game On Sports. Bottom half of the seventh inning coming up here for the Scots. Patrick Turner leading things off. He'll be followed by Preston Gamster and Hunter Krause. We have a new pitcher on the mound for the Lions. That is going to be number 10, Kale Kristofek, now dealing for this seventh inning. The closer for the Lions. The Scots down to their last chance, as they are three outs away from going 0-2 for the day. Turner with a 1-0 count. Ball misses up high for ball two. Kristofek definitely bringing the heat as he deals his 2-0 pitch. That's a chopper over to second base. That'll be picked up by Meyer. He'll throw that one over to first for the first out. Meyer has not been mentioned a whole lot in today's game, as I believe that was his very first putout of the day. And it was. That was his first putout for Meyer. So with one away, brings up Preston Gamster. Gamster, the shortstop, at 1-for-3 with a flyout, lineout, and a single. That single in the third inning. Gamster watches that one, as that one is a called strike on the outside part of the plate. Evening the count, 1-1. Gamster at 6'2", 150 pounds. Favorite player is Trevor Story, favorite MLB player. Two and one now the count. As Gamster ready in the right-handed box. Here he comes. Misses down low for 3-1. The hitter's count coming up to Gamster. Kristofek comes home. Misses down low for ball four. And that is a 3-1 walk for Gamster as the first base runner in this seventh inning. One out, one on, and Hunter Krause coming up to the plate. Krause,
third baseman,
at 1-for-3 as well with a double and two flyouts. Those flyouts to shortstop and left field. Kristofek has his sign from Baker. Looks over at first and then comes home. Misses down low and outside for ball one. Looks like tonight's game will wrap up action for day one of the Scotland Yard Classic. Day two will be tomorrow. And both of those games will once again be here on Game On Sports. Count at 2-0 with one out, one on. Scott's trailing 8-5. Kristofek comes home. And that is a called strike, bringing the count to 2-1. Pitch misses down low. Good stop there from Baker, as that'll bring the hitter's count up now to Krause. Again, named the hitter's count because on the 3-1 count, you can almost expect a fastball somewhere in the strike zone or close to the strike zone. Most likely the best pitch that you will get in that at bat. 3-1. That pitch is a called strike on the outside part of the plate, brings count to full at 3-2. And Harrison Duggar going to come back up to bat for that last at bat of the night. Ball misses down low for ball four on that full count. Back-to-back walks as Gamster heads on to second. Harrison Duggar coming in now to pinch hit, it seems, for Jack Jackson. And it looks like we will have a pitching change as Kristofek heads on out, and that is a short outing for the right-hander. We're pitching change on the mound for the McKinney Lions. Will have that name for you when we come back.
Pitching for McKinney. Number four, Josh Roloff.
Back in action, bottom half of the seventh inning. New pitcher in for the Lions is... that is going to be Josh Roloff coming from shortstop now on the mound. So we have a new shortstop in. As that looks like number six. Yes, that is number six at short. That's going to be Vince Meyer, now at short. So Meyer at short and a new second baseman now too. Ball misses for ball. At second now, that's going to be Bryce Johnson. Lots of changes here as Johnson was at third.
And then we'll see who's at third now. Big swing and a miss from Duggar. At third base, that is going to be Seth Cox, who was at first. Now the first baseman. Having to check all of these one at a time. Ball lifted in to right field. That'll be brought in. That one brought in by Sydney Ward, who is still at right field. Been at right field that whole game as Duggar goes down. That F9. Now that first baseman can't see that number. Wait for him to turn around here. Curtis now up at the plate. Curtis, the right fielder. That ball is lifted into shallow right field. That'll be called on by Johnson, and he'll make the grab for the third out, and that will be ball game. The McKinney Lions take the win by a score of 8-5 over the Scots here tonight. The Scots go 0-2 for the day, but still a lot of baseball to be played as they will have two more games, and that'll be tomorrow at 11 and 6:30 p.m. So be sure to stop and listen to Highland Park Scots baseball tomorrow at 11 a.m. for everybody involved in today's broadcast. And for our producer, Fred Garner, I am Lincoln Revel saying so long for the night from Scotland Yard in Highland Park, Texas. Good night, Scots fans, and God bless.